Hello YouTube, this is Anterect 123. Today we're going to assemble a multiple wave oscillator based on the design of George Lakhovsky. I finished assembling that device about 1 month ago. So we're going to show you how it is assembled and make a little demonstration. As you can see, the apparatus is rather heavy, so I need some kind of transporting device to help me to carry it around. The first demonstration is going to be with my little mica. Sean is only because it is warm today and I want the dogs to be as comfortable as possible. You can see the apparatus is relatively simple. There's an on-on switch. There is the timer. There is the amperometer. There is the variac, which with that we can control the voltage sent to the transformer inside the machine, going from nothing to up to 130 volts. And there's the control for the spark gap that controls the distance between the gap. As you can notice, the finition is not complete. I still have to do the finition, change the knob for a nicer knob here. But the apparatus is still fully operational and we can use it until the finition is finished. The cage resting on her cushion very comfortably. As you can see, she is in the axis of between both antennas. And as you can see also, I removed the metal grids here to replace it by a net, so the metal will not interfere with the signal sent by the antennas here. It's recommended that for small animals and weak people, that the power of the machine will be between 2.5 and 3.5 amp.
Okay, let's start the machine. Let's turn the switch on and we're going to set the timer to about 10 minutes. Then we are going to adjust the variac to about 40 volts. Since I'm using a very powerful transformer, I don't need to turn the variac very high to get some real power coming out of the transformer. At 40 volt, I should be able to get between 2.5 and 3.5 amperes on the ampere meter. We can also adjust the strength of the signal by the distance in the spark gap. That will also affect the power going to the antenna as the frequency of the signal itself. See, then Miket is absolutely relaxed in her cage. The exposition to the multiple wave oscillator is absolutely painless. There's no sensation at all involved with the exposition. We're going to let Miket in there for about 10 minutes, then switch for my Dobermans. Then afterward, I will rearrange the setting to show how the system can be set for a person to be exposed to the multiple wave oscillator.
The 10-minute exposure with Miket is terminate. Now we're going to let her out and change dog and put one of my dopes inside. As you can see, the little Miket is perfectly happy, did not suffer at all, did not feel anything. Yes, yes.
Okay, now it is the turn of my female Doberman Aria. As you can see, she is wearing a special collar. It is what we call a Lakhovsky oscillating circuit. That will be the subject of another video later on. So we're going to put her in the cage and she will be submitted to the multiple wave oscillator for another 10 minutes. Then afterward, we'll be doing the same thing with the male. And then reorganize the setup for a person. As you can see, my female Doberman is perfectly relaxed. The cycle just finished. We are going to let her out and replace her by my male Doberman.
As you can see, the dogs are not stressed out at all. Must be the 7 or 8 sessions they have with the machine, and they are not stressed out. They are very relaxed, and for them it's very fun. Another session of about 10 minutes.
Okay, here, just to show you, the dog is perfectly relaxed, do not feel anything whatsoever. He's comfortably installed on his blanket, and he's perfectly aligned in the axis of the antennas. And he will probably just fall asleep in the cage, and we let him out in about 10 minutes. Okay, now the 10 minutes sitting for my boys is now over. We are going to rearrange the setting to show how a person can be installed to benefit the multiple wave oscillator.
So this is the way a person will normally sit between the antenna and the Lakhovsky Multiple Wave Oscillator. You don't feel any pain, you don't feel anything. There's no effluvia being emitted by the machine, by the antenna. Of course, if I get close to the machine, we'll have a spark, and that's never very pleasant. But if you keep a reasonable distance between me and the antenna, the signal have only shot. This is why I put the cage, the animal in the cage, so I make sure the animal do not touch the antenna. Otherwise, it will be a very unpleasant experience and the dog will not want to do it the next time. So you have to use your head. And you can also change orientation, like that. So one session you can do it on one side, the next session on the other side, or you can interrupt the session at this time to change orientation. You decide. See in a few seconds for you, when you get gas outside, we'll see some interesting effects when you get gas. See you in a few seconds.